Hey guys, this is Magic Synchro, Veritable Turtle Gaming.
And we're back. It's another Breakfast of the Wild. Here we are playing a wonderful game again. And we're going to use a different mic this time, hopefully. And I use that term loosely. Hopefully we're not going to have the horrible noise that we had last time, the weird clicking noises and all that really horrible, horrible stuff. Let's see. Get the live chat loaded up here. So last we left off, he's at the Shrine of Resurrection after defeating the first two shrines that the old man put in front of us. And we're going to see what we can do about the last two shrines on the Great Plateau. Hoping to have this, like yesterday, about an hour-long stream. Starting a little bit earlier than what the actual scheduled event was. Sorry about that if anybody was waiting for that. Just kind of got antsy to play, you know? So our next two shrines, one's down here, and one's over there. So we'll go toward red. Here. That's where we got the pepper plants from. All right. Get some shrimmage. And that's one thing I really do like about the game here, guys, is that pretty much anywhere that you wander around in this game is going to have some form of a health restoration item. So desperate times, desperate measures, and whatnot, you are going to be hard-pressed to find yourself low on food or low on any kind of item to kind of save yourself. Now, it does happen. Let's not get crazy here. I have died a number of times because I did not have something either cooked or prepped or anything along those lines. All right, now we have this nice little goblin camp. What are we looking at? Five arrows? Got a sword about to break. Alright. Let's see here. We've got us a lookout over here too. Arrows dropped for us. He hasn't alerted the other guys yet.
Oh.
Another bow for us, some arrows. Arrow for the shot we missed. This little chest. Put the bow away. Ooh. That's good to see. See if we can't gather us some arrows, though. Some regular arrows. Can we have one of these clothes already? Yeah. Let's, how far I let out before we dump it. This one's not, though. This is another thing that I love about this game, guys, is these boxes here, fully flammable, they're gonna roast, and if they have any food items inside of them, it's gonna actually turn into a roasted whatever the item is. And at the low level that I'm at, I don't really care about having uncooked apples or simmered fruits or uncooked acorns for nutty this or nutty that. I'm dealing with 3 hearts here. So I'm not looking for anything that's like 6 or 7 hearts of food or 10 or 20 or something along those lines. So having that is just fine. I pull out my club again. Carry this torch over here. Way. Wow. This whole treasure trove of stuff here. And I gotta be honest, first time I played this, guys, I was nowhere near as explorative in this little tutorial area. There's stuff that I know I missed, and this right here is actually one of them. And part of that's because I just didn't have real good skill with the game itself, and I mean, if you think I'm bad right now, you should have seen me a couple of weeks ago when I first started playing the game. But yeah, it's just more and more just neat as to what you get to do inside this game. Here's the old dude.
Hmm.
Not too impressed with my cooking, is he? Well, challenge accepted, old dude. Let's see what we can find here. Some peppers. Ah, some clay pots. Ah, another pepper. An axe. Do I have an axe already? I do. Okay. Time to get rid of worthless things in place of an axe, though. Because axes are really handy. You can do all sorts of really cool things with an axe. The most important in my mind is... excuse me. As I was saying before, I started choking on my own spit, apparently, is the most important thing you can do with it is cut down trees and kind of make them fall over to get either scrap wood for building your own fire later, which I'll be grabbing probably later, or to make a bridge. Spicy meat and seafood fry. Okay. So, raw meat, spicy peppers, hold the pepper, I don't have any raw meat. So I need some raw meat. Didn't I have meat? Well, that was cooked meat. Yeah, I got cooked meat over here. Okay. I believe I can actually... Nope, I can't cook with cooked meat. So I need to find me some kind of animal. Thank you. I know that's not very sportsmanlike, but don't remember this being a sport. So yeah, killing those guys before they can fight back. Really good tactic, in my opinion. Hopefully they had some kind of meat stored away for any day. Dash nabbit. It appears that that was not the case for them. What arrows do I have? Bomb arrows. Oh, what the heck are they doing giving me bomb arrows this early in the game? My gosh. Oh. This is still the quest for raw meat, but we're also trying to get these shrines out of the way, so saw some kind of Korok scared the golden poop out of it. Hey, Hoyin. I hope I pronounced that right. Yeah, it's a great game. I've had it for a couple weeks now. Finally got everything set up to where I can stream it, and it's beautiful. It is extremely detailed in what you're capable of doing in this game. I completely recommend it. And it is definitely one of the, like, two or three reasons to own a Nintendo Switch right now. And one of the very few reasons to own a Wii U. This is the Switch version that I'm playing. Actually, I'll just keep this where it is. These guys get a bomb arrow, I think. Looks like there's plenty of handfuls up the side of the mountain, so I should be able to get up just fine. Oh yeah, and the ridiculous thing about this game is this plus the Switch, plus the pre-order bundle I did was like $460, and I consider it completely worth it. And the bundle that I got was the Switch, Zelda, plus the DLC pass, which they've already got two DLCs announced this year for it. and two other bonus games, Snipper Clips, which is a fun game for like puzzle goers, and Bomberman. And Bomberman is just ridiculous on this as well. It takes me back to when I was like in the 90s playing with my buddies at home. But yeah, man, it's a great game. I can't recommend it enough. It's totally open-ended. I've got two save games going right now, the one that I'm streaming here and the one that I've got that's ridiculously further along than this. And I've discovered things on this playthrough. That I've had no clue. Yeah, it was a real good deal. And the real crazy thing about it is it was GameStop that was doing the package, and the package was, you know, they were sold out everywhere, and you couldn't even get them online. But if you'd go into a GameStop and actually order the bundle deal that they had, they would deliver it to your home for free, so no shipping cost. So I actually had jury duty a couple weeks ago, and come home from jury duty one day, and it was there on my doorstep waiting for me, and I was like, oh my god. Because it actually wasn't supposed to ship for like three later days, so it even got there early. And it was just, you know, it was just awesome because I've been hunting for a damn thing for a while. But yeah, the graphics are great. I'm actually streaming this at 720. But this is actually a 1080. So as good as it looks on the stream, it's even better on my television set. And that's just kind of silly to say, or ridiculous to say, but it is. And yeah, right now I'm on the little intro tutorial island. Yeah, this is 720 that I'm streaming at. And yeah, it's just ridiculous the way it looks between the TV and the way it's streaming right now. It makes me wish that I'd actually gotten the higher capacity stream system. Yeah, it's just beautiful. And it's not that really cheesy cel shading that they had for Wind Waker, but it's still kind of stylistic like that. So it just works really well for the franchise. So out of all the mechanics in the game, the stasis mechanic is by far my favorite, because the way it works is there's certain things that use kinetic motion and you're able just to stop them. There's an upgrade that you'll get later in the game, and it actually not only stops inanimate objects, but it actually stops the creatures and enemies in the game, which totally changes the way the game plays out at that point. Might have been able to make it up there for the next ball game, but don't like taking my chances. Oh, that was me whiffing. Can I get through? Yeah, sweet. Yeah, it is, and I didn't even use the, so what was that? Was that a shield? Okay. One annoying thing is the game doesn't consider you actually having looted a treasure chest unless you get the item out of it and keep the item out of it. So I have to drop my thing and grab the other one. But the real cool thing is since it's storing kinetic energy when you freeze the items, you can actually hit them and it'll build up more and more kinetic. And then finally just blast off. And Here's a sledgehammer to help me illustrate that point. Way cool. And at the end of each one of these little shrines, there's this spirit guardian, basically a mummified elder from before the big, huge, nasty cataclysm happened. And they give you a little spirit orb, which is currency to buy upgrades, extra stamina bar or extra heart bar. Oh, don't cry, man. You'll be able to find a copy. I mean, there's three different ways to play, technically. You can play on the Wii U. You can play on the Switch. And supposedly there's an emulation project going for it. I don't personally recommend it because, currently, from what I've been told, it is extremely buggy. It's not reliable, and it doesn't have all the mechanics in it, number one. And number two, as a game developer, I completely believe in helping those companies out there that are trying to develop games. Mainly, the more games that we help them develop by paying for them, the better the games are going to get. And it's way too cold to progress. So, do I have any spicy cooked food? I do. All right. So eating the spicy cooked foods allows you to traverse in the cold temperatures. It is like a lot of other survival games out there. You have different biomes, and I have made it into the snow biome. And it's going to require me to stay warm. Guys up by blowing up all the barrels. Give me some arrows. Oh, I agree. When it comes to emulation, there's nothing that compares to the original hardware in most cases. Some games are great for PC, and I have no problem with that. I've actually have a Raspberry Pi 3 and a Raspberry Pi B Plus and a Pi Zero. I have emulators on those. Now, one of the things that I do with emulation, though, is I own the hardware and I own the software, and I use the emulator basically as a space saver. In my household right now, I have two Xbox 360s, a Wii, two Dreamcasts, a 64, an SNES, an NES, a GameCube, a Genesis. All that takes up a shit ton of space. And just to save it, I'll use an emulator. But certain games, they gotta be played on the original hardware. So like my NES, it's hooked up. My SNES, it's hooked up. My GameCube, it's hooked up. The 64, it's connected as well. The Genesis, connected. So I don't save a whole lot of space on some of that stuff. But yeah. Let's see, am I making it? Oh, I actually wound up climbing up way too high. Well, what the heck's at the top of the summit here then? First playthrough I did of this particular area, I was not prepared. I had like maybe a minute of cold resistance. Oh wow. Old dude's up here.
Ooh.
Hmm. Oh, cool. That'll work.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. I don't have the Xbox One. It's kind of weird. This is the only current gen console I have. I've got a couple gaming computers, but the PS4 and the Xbox One, a couple of the games looked all right, but it just didn't grab me like the 360 and the PS3 did. And truth be told, the PS3 I had, I actually won it from a company raffle thing. The company I work for is awesome. I recommend working for Korok Communications if you ever are in an area where they employ people. They take real good care of their employees. I've been with them forever almost. And they just gave me a PS3 with the PS3 Move. I had two games for it, and that was Little Big Planet and Infamous. Both those games were great, but the console and the way it worked and everything just wasn't a fan. Also was pretty off-put by the PS2 that I used to have. Yeah, it was awesome. I was happy when I won the console. I had the Move game that came with it also. It just didn't seem like it stacked up compared to what the actual Wii was doing as far as motion controls were concerned. She fight one of these guys. That'll work. Wait, did I say something about Wisconsin? I don't remember saying something about Wisconsin. Oh, Wisconsin. Cox. Yeah. Yeah, they do not service the Wisconsin area, unfortunately. I don't know if I blew anybody up with that or not. I only got a couple. Well, I've still got that warm doublet iron, so I'm not too worried about my cold resistance. This is cold water. Yep, that's super cold water. Let's see. Oh, I know what I'm about to do. But yeah, the PS3 wasn't too impressed. The Xbox 360, I own two of them. Great games, great catalog. The backwards compatibility was one of the things that I really wanted out of it. I really thought that the PS3 was going to be great because it started off being an open system with Linux. But then they went back on that. They found out it basically opened it up to hacking too much. And so I kind of put it away at that point. But yeah, the current gen of both of the systems, PS4 and Xbox One, I just really haven't seen anything on the consoles that's exclusive to the console that I can't just do on the computer. And those two systems, for what they are, they're just specialized PCs. The Switch is as well to a point, but the portability that it offers is just super awesome in my opinion. I mean, the fact that, like I said, I got this while I was doing jury duty. I charged it at home. I took it with me to the courtroom. I was playing Zelda in the court area and the juror assembly room. I brought it to work with me to play during lunch break and shifts down. I mean, it downscales to 720 when it's the handheld. I can deal with that. I mean, you're seeing it at 720 right now, and it's beautiful. So it doesn't really make me want to go, oh, God, it's so horrible. I don't see what people's beef with it being 720 is. Now, I'm not a huge snob when it comes to graphics either. I mean, there's some games that I play. I mean, one of the games that I love right now on PC is 7 Days to Die. And it definitely doesn't have the graphics to write home about. Let's see. Can I lift this gate with this? Is that what it is? Yeah, the new power that this room had is the... Let's see. I am definitely not going to like this. And the real neat thing about these trials, to be totally honest, is there's not one way to deal with them. Alright, so I gotta get rid of my Traveler Spear to get another Traveler Spear. That's fine. Appreciate that, man. Always care for a sub. And yeah, sub, like, everything, man, it's always well appreciated. And I'll talk to you later, man. That's right. I got a treasure chest up here to get a hold of. Oh, such a rush to get to the next stage of the quest. Forgot about that. Can't leave any good treasure behind. Just not really in the spirit of the game that way. Mushmouth, thanks for joining the stream, man. Appreciate you watching. Just finished the fourth shrine here in the little tutorial area for Breath of the Wild. And I'll probably be streaming for about another 20 minutes or so. To the last shrine we completed, which was the Cryonis shrine, mainly because I forgot that right here is something we can get. I have actually not beaten the game yet. This is my second play. Mainly I restarted it so the stream wouldn't be halfway through the game. The first play that I've got right now, I've actually got one of the Divine Beasts defeated. And I've just made it to the Korok Forest in Lost Woods. So, working on getting the Master Sword, I've got 11 hearts. According to a guy I work with, he said you need 13 to actually get the Master Sword, so got to find like 8 more shrines. But this little island area, yeah, I've beaten it, and I've beaten the Rito Divine Beast. I think that's Ruta or something. Without an eyeball. That'll work. Have you played the game by any chance, Mushmouth? Yeah, that's what I've heard, is when you fight Ganon and beat him, the game's just kind of just done and over with. And geez, seems like a not a good design on that part. I mean, it's so open-ended and open world, but I guess there has to be a, you know, a credit screen at some point in the game, so might as well be then. But that's awesome, man. Oh, hey, it's what? So the game does not end after beating Ganon? That's cool. have them camped. Looks like we just got the guides keeping point. Do I have any basic arrows? Nope. Just bomb arrows and ice arrows. Appreciate the sub, man. This is actually on my secondary PC that I'm streaming through with a capture device. So normally there would be something that would tell me that somebody subbed. I just realized I didn't turn on the stream capture though, so appreciate it, man. I'm going to be trying to stream this game every morning around 8 a.m. But I can put one of those up. And I usually try to, you know, goblins, man. They're the best. The things you can do with them. Is just awesome. Just the way they got their AI all set up. Appreciated. Every morning around 8 a.m. Eastern, I'm gonna play stream this game for now. Next week is gonna be an exception. I work a company that basically decided to tell me that I had training next week in the mornings. I normally work overnight, so it's usually not an issue. So next week, the streaming schedule won't be usual 8 a.m., but in the evenings, I do try to stream some other stuff depending upon the day of the week. Typically, Monday nights is when that will happen. Oh, that's awesome. Bokoblin mask. So kind of like how Majora's mask, they had different masks that you kind of blend into stuff. That's cool. To pass up, and this is a spiked bubble shield. Okay. Yeah, my other playthrough, I have not found that merchant you speak of, so that's way cool. That's something to definitely look forward to in the game. That's okay, man. I'm just streaming just to stream and to have fun. If you guys are wanting to watch, then that's great. If you guys aren't able to make it, that's fine too. You know, it's just kind of casual gameplay we're doing here. It's not like I'm hardcore streaming or something, you know. I've seen some guys like that. They're like, you haven't been here forever. Why haven't you been here? Don't you love me? Nah, that's not my thing, man. Yeah, I'm trying to be spoiler-free for most of my playthroughs, but a couple guys at work, they play the game, and they've had the Switch longer than I've had the Switch, for starters, so that doesn't bode well for me having spoiler-free with those guys. And it's always, hey, have you got this? Have you done that? Where are you at so far? So there's been a few things that I haven't been able to be away from, like the Master Sword and how many hearts it requires. One guy managed to tell me the secret to the Hidden Forest. He's like, oh, you're about to get to the Hidden Forest. I'm like, the what? He's like, the Lost Woods. I'm like, oh. He's like, yeah, there's a secret trick to getting through it. I was like, oh, well, I'd like to figure that out. And he just blabs it out. I was like, oh, well, that kind of sucks. Because, you know, I'm one of those guys that I like the challenge. I like puzzle solving. And being able to figure shit out like that is just a big win in my book. And they kind of took that away from me. So, but, you know, if somebody slips out a spoiler, then, you know, that happens. Yeah, I definitely like streams more than vids too, man. I like the live camaraderie, you know, the conversation that everybody can have with it. I like the fact that it's interactive. There's a streamer that I actually follow that does a lot of PC streams. And I really recommend watching their stuff to people. Dalm Entertainment, if you search for them, some of my streams that I have in my actual... My vids, actually have them linked, because I do, when I do my evening streams, I actually play with them. Set these on fire. See if we can get some roasted food out of them. but yeah, live streams definitely, man, is where I get a lot of my entertainment at. I work a night job. It's a desk job. Yeah, the Lost Woods are definitely frustrating. I've gotten one of the trials done on my other playthrough. And getting that far was difficult. The trick that the guy had told me at work turned out to be mostly false, at least the way it was working out for me. He said something about the dudes and the scary trees and stuff like that, but that didn't seem to hold much water. Let me just go ahead and mark this with a pin real quick. Not a stamp, a pin. But yeah, it definitely, though, I like streaming. It's fun. You know, it kind of gets everybody excited about the game, and with the way that you can interact, it's almost like you get to play the game with me, right? I mean, if I'm doing something stupid or if I'm not figuring something out, you guys can offer hints or suggestions, and I can either accept them or not. And usually I'll accept suggestions because I realize that I'm not the best gamer. I'm actually just a, you know, guy here having fun. But occasionally I'll not take a suggestion. Yeah, I've gotten through the Lost Woods as well. Has something to do with the way the torch works is all I can figure out because of the torch puzzle at the beginning. But I've actually got to where I can fast travel, so I'm good with knowing what the actual secret is for future. That's kind of funny. You kill a squirrel and it's an acorn instead of an actual piece of meat. Okay, that's cool. So, like, the wind that kind of whistles through the whole place, I guess, moves the... All right, that's neat. And so that's one of the things I tell people about this game, is just stuff like that is just... The little nuances in this game is just awesome. Just the little tiny details that they do for stuff like that, like the, let's see, is this, no, that's not the place I'm looking for. Like, this is something I really like, is the shield surfing thing. I'm not too good at it, but it's just neat that they'll do stuff like that in this game. And the fact that it allows you to traverse different areas. And the stasis pranks you can play on the bokoblins are awesome. I got the second tier of stasis on the other playthrough that I'm doing, and so you can actually freeze the enemies. I'm sure you guys know about that. But one of my favorite things to do is to freeze a bokoblin that has something in his hands and just watch him try to figure out what the heck's happened after I go and do it and steal it or knock it out. Like, I've seen one where they'll actually pick up a metal object and you just use magnesis on it and take it out of their hands from them. Yeah, certain enemies can fight each other. I've heard that too. A buddy of mine talked about how you can get the cuckoos, the chicken dudes, how you can weaponize them. Like, beat on them until they're about to go nuclear, and then throw one at somebody else. Yeah, apparently there's an issue with archers in getting too close to them and ducking to where they'll shoot over your heads. I've kind of noticed that with mounted archers, to where they can't hit you if you're like kind of moving around, and so you can get them to shoot each other. But other than that, I don't know if there's like a faction system for all of them or not, but that would be kind of my guess. I have not froze a bokoblin on horse yet. That sounds hilarious. And yeah, Ed, I agree. The map is just huge. There's stuff on this playthrough of the Plateau that this is my second play, and I'm finding stuff that I didn't see the first time at all. Like earlier, there's a bokoblin camp, and it had a beehive in it, and that was the first beehive that I'd seen on the Plateau, but in my first playthrough I completely missed it, completely passed it over. The warm doublet that the old man gives you here, I actually had not gotten it the first time that I played through from him. I didn't actually make it all the way up to the summon. Hey, Shadow. In this game, the cake's actually real, man. You can make a cake. So there's no cake is a lie in this one. So that's definitely a huge boost. To the top of this place. I definitely want to get to the paraglider before I call it a day, guys. So that's my goal at the moment. And generally, like I was saying, I stream from 8 to 9 Eastern. And I try to make that my goal, is to get to a good stopping point. So sometimes it'll end a little sooner, sometimes a little end later. And this time it looks like it's going to end a little bit right on the nose. There's that ladder. It was right over there. Boy, I felt silly. Ancient armor set, Jeremy. I actually don't know what that is. And I agree, Moosh. Magnesis to move guardians would be awesome. Can you make waffles? Not that I'm aware of. But I'm not 100% clued into what all the cooking allows for at the moment. So it is possible, I guess. I just haven't found it, maybe. But yeah, as far as the ancient armor set goes, it could be something that you could just get with like an amiibo or something, I guess, because I know there's a lot you can do with the amiibos, but that takes like real world money, and I've already put $460 into getting well the Switch and all the accessories to start playing, so
now then,
probably going to not do the real world money thing for a lot of other stuff.
I was King Rome Boss Pharamus.
Spoiler alert coming on, guys. This is a big, huge plot point, supposedly.
The last leader of Hyrule. A kingdom which no longer exists. The Great Calamity was merciless. It devastated everything in its path, Lo. A century ago, it was then that my life was taken away from me. And since that time, here I have remained in spirit
form. Oh, yeah.
I did not think it wise to overwhelm you while your memory was still fragile.
And in some spots,
I thought it best to assume a temporary form. Forgive me. I think you are now ready.
Yeah, as far as Zelda goes, the fact that this is the first game that's had heavy voice acting in it that's not listen over and over again is a
wonderful move. One must know the story from an age long past. The Demon King was born into this kingdom, but his transformation into malice created the horror you see now. Stories of Ganon were passed from generation to generation in the form of legends and fairy tales. But there was also a prophecy. The signs of a resurrection of Calamity Ganon are clear, and the power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. We decided to heed the prophecy and began excavating large areas of land. It wasn't long before we discovered several ancient relics made by the hands of our distant ancestors. These relics, the divine beasts, were giant machines piloted by warriors.
This seems like just kind of a dumb moment coming through the storyline, right? Like, we have this big, huge catastrophe coming up, guys, so let's try to figure out what we can do.
This coincided.
Oh, here's these ancient, like, Megazord, Voltron Force things that we have no clue what we're doing with. And all these itty-bitty, like, elemental bots.
And her appointed knight.
Let's see what we can do. Let's hack them and program them to kind of be rudimentary automatons. What's the worst that could happen, right?
100 years ago, there was a princess set to inherit.
Kind of seems like a voluntary, let's just cause a robot uprising, guys. Yeah, these things will never betray their masters. They won't bite the hand that feeds them.
We selected four skilled individuals
from every single bad cheesy sci-fi
and tasked them with the duty
Armageddon
of
movie ever,
the divine
right?
beasts. With the princess as their commander, we dubbed these pilots champions, a name that would solidify their unique bond. The princess, her appointed knight, and the rest of the champions were on the brink of sealing away Ganon. But nay. Ganon was cunning, and he responded with a plan beyond our imagining.
Yeah, I know, Shadow. That's just... It just reeks of just horribleness. It's It's like, hey, this mega huge awesome weapon
from deep below
that was
Hyrule
used in
Castle
ancient times. There's no way he could be cursed.
The guardians and the divine beasts turn against us. The champions lost
2,000 rupees isn't too bad, Jeremy. So you're looking at like 6,000 for each piece.
Lapsed while defending the princess.
At 2,000 rupees,
thus,
depending upon
was
what you're doing, like a couple of fights with a Talus will easily get that for you, because they'll
however
break up into all the precious
the princess
gemstones
survived to face Ganon alone.
Link, you are our final hope. The fate of Hyrule rests with you.
That princess was my own daughter, my dear Zelda. And the courageous knight who protected her right
so,
up
like,
to the very end.
Gears and ancient pieces and
that
stuff
knight
for each one, that's
was none other than you, Link.
That's not as cool, depending upon
you
the prince
you need,
but they're still kind of plentiful.
When your fate took an unfortunate turn.
Depending upon what they are.
And then,
or how many
you were taken
need
to the Shrine of Resurrection. Here you now stand, revitalized 100 years later. The words of guidance you have been hearing since your awakening are from Princess Zelda herself. Even now, as she works to restrain Ganon from within Hyrule Castle, she calls out for your help. However, my daughter's power will soon be exhausted. Once that happens, Ganon will freely regenerate himself, and nothing will stop him from consuming our land. Considering that I could not save my own kingdom, I have no right to ask this of you, Link.
I like how Link's expression in that last little segment
but
there was just this blank
here
kind of staring off in the distance.
You must save her.
It's like,
my
well, dude, you're saying a lot of stuff, and you kind of put a whole lot
Ganon
on my shoulders here. Okay,
somehow,
this kind of sucks, but
Ganon
I guess it's what I am.
Ganon has maintained control over all four divine beasts, as well as those guardians swarming around Hyrule Castle. I believe it would be quite reckless for you to head directly to the castle at this point. I suggest that you make your way east out to one of the villages in the wilderness. Follow the road out to Kakariko Village. There you will find the Elder Impa.
Oh yeah.
She will tell
that's,
you more.
That's
about
something
the
that I like
Impa's
the fact
ahead
that they kept in this is that
consult the map
you're
on your
sheet
slate for the precise location
voice acting
of Kakariko
goes
Village.
But you definitely have
make your
you
way
know,
past the twin summits of the dueling peaks.
So
from
it's
there,
you know kind of a toss up. You can
north.
There's some responses you can have in this game that are kind of dickish. Yeah, that's right, Shadow. He lets his bow and his arrow and his sword and his stick and his soup ladle. All that does the talking for him. That's a nice bow compared to everything else I got in the inventory. Mr. Bokobo, you're gonna go away. See you, Moosh. Yeah, guys, we're about to call it here. I think the last thing that I'm gonna do before calling it quits for the day is I'm going to paraglide, because paragliding is fun as hell. And I'm going to go out to the Shrine of Resurrection, because there should be a Korok seed in the shrine now that I've actually done all this. And I think that would be an excellent way to kind of stop it here. Wait, that's not what I wanted to hit him with. finally got some meat. But the guy's no longer there for me to cook his favorite dish for him, so that's kind of sad. Well, since you broke my sword with your face, I'll take your club. That's still where I'm going, yep. That's on the shrine. Okay. We'll just fast travel at this point. I was completely confused in my directions. Maps are my kryptonite, but I'm about to go to bed, I guess. Here yet. But yeah, guys, I think we're going to actually call it quits at this point, and I'll be here again tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. Eastern. So appreciate you guys watching the stream tonight. Like, comment, share, subscribe, do all those really cool things that you can do to say that you knew me before I was famous, like I'll ever get famous. But hey, appreciate you all coming, and yeah, I think that's going to be it.